hearty good morning to one and all present over here. Today's promise verse is taken from Jeremiah 1:5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Yes, my dear friends, we have a God who knows us from inside out. Our anxieties, our worries, our strength, our weakness, every single thing of us, He knows. And the best part is, He still loves us, even though He knows us the whole. So why don't we, with this assurance, let's begin this new academic year and this day with a word of prayer. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Our God, Heavenly, Gracious Father, Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. Lord, we thank and praise you for your grace, mercy, and love towards us, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you for bringing us all safe back to this campus after a vacation, Lord Jesus. For students, those who are still traveling, Lord, we pray that you bring them safe. Lord, we pray for this assembly and this day, Lord Jesus, even as we begin this day. Lord, we pray, let your mighty hand be upon us. Be with us, Lord Jesus. Everything we do, let it glorify your name. You be the teacher, you be the guide, and you be the instructor. We submit everything into your mighty hands. You take complete control. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let's join with the choir in singing.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whispers of love in the dead of night, and you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. Who you are, and I'm loved by you.
very good morning to one and all. It's such a good thing to see you all back, because the campus was looking so dull without you all, and the shopkeepers were, you know, counting the days, when will the students come so that we can have our messes open. You know, you can see the joy on the shopkeepers, you know, the barbers and all. They're so happy and excited because you guys are back. So why don't you tell your neighbor and say, hey, you look awesome. So nice to have you back. Good. That's nice. Those who are still searching for a seat, just find it and sit. See, the new things always excites us. When I bring some new gift to my children, you should see their excitement. They jump. They go round and round, and they, you know, they start singing a song, and they are so excited to grab a gift. Maybe, you know, I'm sure you would have noticed that in little children. There was a time when we were also small, and we used to get excited about new things, small things. Small things used to excite us. New things used to bring a lot of joy on our face. But as we grow older, we try to think a lot. We think we have become more matured, but sometimes we ignore the little things that are happening around. It's a new beginning. God is doing something new. God has added a new semester in our lives. But how can you enjoy the new? That's what the Lord wants us to know today. If you want to enjoy the new, you need to have a new language. You need to have a new lens. You need to have a new listening. Without that, you cannot enjoy the new that God is adding, and we might still roll on to the old ways, and we might still end up murmuring instead of enjoying the new. Let me explain it. God wants us to have a new lens where we see what God sees. Because what God sees is different, and that's how God wants us to see every situation. When we look around, we see problems, but when God looks at a situation, He sees the promising end. So God today wants us to not look or focus on the problems, but He wants us to focus on the promises. Because when we hold on to the promises will unlock the provisions for those circumstances. When there were 5,000 people gathered to hear the voice of Jesus, Jesus knew that they were hungry, and Jesus wanted food to be arranged. And you know something, what happened? The disciples, the people who were learned and they knew all the maths, they said, no, it's not possible to feed. But there was a little child who had 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He said, Jesus, take my 5 loaves and 2 fishes, because I know you can multiply. What do you see determines the way you will take up the new things. God wants us to see the promises instead of seeing the problems. Because when you see the promises and cling on to God, through those promises, those are the keys which will unlock the provision of God for your life. Second, God wants us to hear what He hears. There were a group of people who brought an adulterous woman, and they started to accuse her, telling that Jesus, this woman was caught in the act of adultery, and let's stone her to death. All that you could hear in the audience was the sound of the critics and the voice of condemnation. But Jesus had a different ear. He was able to hear the cry of this woman who was crying for mercy. You might be surrounded by different noises and the sounds of the world, but God wants you to hear what He hears. God wants you to hear the promptings of the Holy Spirit's, you know, the voice that comes to you when all around you starts to shake in the storm. Joshua and Caleb heard the voice of the Holy Spirit telling that these Canaanites can be driven by the power of the Lord. But the others were so scared because of the voice they heard that was so fearful. God wants us to hear what He hears. third thing that God wants us to have for this new season is a new language. God wants us to declare His verdicts, not the verdicts of the world. Don't be led by the world, but you lead the world. God has called us as a light to this world, where you define what the world should look like, not the world should tell you how you should look like. There was a demon-possessed man in the Bible by the Lake of Gadarenes, and all that he was doing was he was bruising himself, he was naked, and his own family rejected him, and all that they pronounced over him was a verdict of doom. They said, this guy is not worthy to be taken inside. All that we need to do is just pronounce him dead and for destruction. But Jesus took an amazing journey, and he reaches the spot, and there he heals this demon-possessed guy who was naked and bruised and broken. And Jesus, he declares destiny over this guy, telling that you will become a messenger of peace to 10 cities. That is the verdict of destiny. In the new season, God wants us to declare the verdict of destiny instead of declaring the verdict of doom. What are you seeing? What are you hearing? What are you pronouncing? It will define how you enjoy the new season in your life. So I pray that with the help of the Holy Spirit and with the help of Jesus, we will see what He sees and we will declare what He declares. Let's pray together for a new language, for a new lens, and for new ears to listen. Father God, we thank you so much for this morning. You have given us a new beginning, and you want us to have new ways of thinking, brilliant perspectives you want us to have, which are your perspectives. So I pray right now, as we dedicate this new beginning, as you have given us a word, you want us to experience the word. So as I'm praying, Holy Spirit, I pray that your hand will touch our ears, your hand will touch our eyes, and your hand will anoint our tongue, that we will see what you see, that we will declare what you declare, and we will hear what you hear, so that everything that pertains to the world and the knowledge of the enemy will fade away. And only what pertains to the knowledge and the truth of God will sustain us. I pray and I bless this community as we begin this new semester. That Holy Spirit, you will empower us to take risks. You will help us to see the things that you see and to claim it by the act of faith. That our students will enjoy good health. Their families will enjoy peace, and their provisions will be met. Their financial situations will always be green and prosperous. I pray that our students will prosper in their studies as they step into this new semester. That our teachers will enjoy wisdom and your peace and divine guidance to take these lovely children to greater heights. We surrender the management as we all stand together as Karunia family. We declare our dependence on you. May your name be glorified in this new semester. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God bless us.